Hello, welcome to Navigating Birds. So today we'll be talking about an important aspect of parenting, that is how important it is to communicate with your kid, with your children, and how to do that effectively. So what do you mean by communication? Is it just talking? Is it the way we command our kids? Or is it just listening to them? An effective communication will involve both talking and listening to kids. Let me start with my case. When Sana was very young, like 6-7 months, yes, it is that young. Since that time, I have started communicating with her. Like, I used to say her and I used to wait for her reaction. She used to make some sounds. I used to appreciate those sounds. I used to acknowledge those sounds as if she is talking back to me. Then I used to again say a story or certain things. Like every day what I'm doing, let us say I just used to say her, Mama, I'm very tired. So she used to look at my expression and she used to give a similar expression as if it was like she's understanding. It started like that and she started speaking very early. Maybe by 12 months she was saying 2 to 3 words, and by 15-16 months almost sentence she used to say. So our communication started really early. Then I started keeping time slot where me and she can talk openly, like for an hour maybe, or maybe half an hour, however it is. We used to talk separately and I used to say her whatever I am feeling, whatever the day is about, and she used to say me the same things. So that is how I started acknowledging her all types of emotions, be it happiness, be it fear, be it her anger. And that is how I used to know what she is feeling, how she is feeling. And that way I never really faced such kind of tantrums which maybe I would have if I would not have communicated properly. So it actually appeared as a blessing to me to have an open communication with her. Moreover, this type of communication needs a very good listener, and be a role model for that. When your child speaks, it might be something which you feel is completely meaningless, is completely out of the box, but you should give your genuine reaction to them as if it is as important to you as it is for your child, so that they feel the trust, they feel the confidence on you, and they know that they can share anything they want with you without any judgment. Always remember, your child's facial expression, body language, your body language, your facial expressions are equally important in communication as much as the words you are saying or hearing are. That way, a day when you feel your child is very silent, or maybe her actions are different, you can easily recognize that and you can call and ask. I have asked n number of times, what happened, Sana? Is it something which is bothering you? Why are you behaving different? Firstly, she used to say, nothing, Mama, I'm fine. And immediately after some time, she would run to me and tell that this and this has happened, or this is what happened with another cousin. And she used to say the whole thing. Or I didn't like the food. It can be that simple also. I didn't like the food. I want this. What happens is that emotions, when they can share with you, the bond you share with each other is phenomenal. And also, when the child knows to express, it is very, very good for their development and for their own life in future. It sends a message that you value your child's thoughts and feelings. I do value. And so it is very important. I would urge all of you who are going through tantrum phase, who are going through overstimulated kids phase, or who are going through sleepless nights, please talk to your kid. Talking has no other replacement. Communication has no other replacement. It is the best thing which you can do for your bonding and also for the development of your child. Thank you for listening. If you agree, please do like, comment, or share.